Hello, massage nurse. Today I'm going to bring you how to treat the psoas muscle and the iliacus, which combined make up the iliopsoas, which is this muscle here that it's a main hip flexor. It flexes your hips, and it's also a back stabilizer along with the quadratus lumborum. So if you tilt it, an anterior tilt, that means the iliacus here, these fibers are pulling down, so this is really tight. If you have a posterior tilt, then that means that the fibers of the psoas major are pulling you really tight. So let's start first with the Thomas test. Now I'm just going to show you something very simple that you can do on your table, you know, so that you can find out if it is the psoas. I'm going to show you three major trigger points and some anatomy. So while your client's laying supine straight, you know, flat, you ask your client to flex this knee all the way up, grab your leg all the way up, pull it as tight as they can, and see how there's quite a bit of space here. That means her psoas is, you know, pulling, so it's tight. It's quite a bit off the table. If it's turning, if the leg is laterally rotated, then that means that the iliotibial band is really hypertonic and tight. And if it's an interior tilt, then that means that the adductors are pulling, and these are hypertonic. So this is where you measure. You could see that there's quite a gap here. Also, if there's a gap on her back, which on her it's not, if there's a lordotic curvature, if you can fit your arm underneath, if there's a gap, then that means her psoas is really hypertonic with her, which is not on her. It's completely flat. Some clients, it really curves and you can really stick your arm in there. The only place where I see something tight on her is that this leg really came off the table. So that's the Thomas test. And if you want to learn more about it, you can just, you know, Google that. So that's the Thomas test. So the psoas originates from T12, L1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the bodies of the transverse processes on the anterior. This muscle goes diagonally, so it doesn't originate here on the anterior part. It originates on the back, on the posterior, right here, the lumbar area. But it crosses diagonally, and it inserts at the lesser trochanter of the femur, and so does the iliacus. The iliacus originates on the anterior part of the ilium bone. Inside. So we drew right here the little edges of it, but it's really on the inside of the ilium. So it joins. So this is the psoas major, and then it joins with the iliacus. It's really pretty big. So it's on the, you know, in the back of this bone, and then it joins, and they both insert on the lesser trochanter of the femur. So this has three major trigger points that you're going to treat, and this is the way you're going to treat it. You're going to make sure that the client's legs are flat on the, that their feet are flat on the table. So bend your knees. You want to relax this muscle. Bend your knees, put your feet flat on the table. There you go. We want to make sure that that muscle is relaxed. You're going to go to the level of her belly button. So you're going to go 2 inches out at the edge, and then 2 inches low right here, so until you get to the belly of the psoas major. Now, there's, of course, you got to go through, you know, the small intestine and large intestine there. So what you're going to do to treat the belly of it, you're going to ask your client to take a deep breath. And on the exhale, you're going to do circular motion and go down. And okay, do another deep breath again. And on the exhale, you go circular motion and go down. And you're using the pads of your fingers, not the tips where you get the finger. But see, you're treating, so you go 2 inches out laterally, and then about two inches low. So you're right on the belly of the psoas major. This trigger point right here, and if it and I can feel it right there on her. Let me see. Need to keep their knees bent. And after she's taken a couple of deep breaths, and you want to make sure that they breathe with their belly, not a diaphragm breathe. Like, take a deep breath with your belly. Bring your belly up. No, she's breathing with her diaphragm. Breathe with your belly again. Extend your belly like it's, there you go. There you go. And then on the exhale, you go clockwise, and I'm right on her psoas major. If this is a trigger point, it'll trigger, they'll feel it in the low back and the lumbar area. So this triggers to the lumbar area, and I'm gonna hold this right here up to about 15 to 20 seconds, keeping it at a level of maybe a 5 or a 6. What number is that for you right there?
6.
Like a 6? Okay, so I'm gonna count, you know, up to about 15, 20 seconds, which I've already done since I've been showing you. And then that should start releasing. She should start feeling that number going down. So now you release gently. You don't just wanna pop out. You release gently. Now I'm gonna go to her ASIS, which is the anterior superior iliac spine. The iliacus is right underneath there. So you're gonna wanna dig in there and try to find it. Some people might be ticklish, so be careful. You know, watch their eyes, you know, make eye contact, so you can be, you know, sensitive if it is too much for them. So I'm going right underneath here and trying to dig my fingers in there, you know, and trying to feel. Here's another trigger point right underneath the ASIS on the, you know, on the anterior part of the bone, but on the inside that I can dig in there. And she's not gonna let me dig in there because it's really hurting. So this right here triggers into the lower part of the abdomen. So if there's a trigger point in there, she's gonna feel it on the anterior part of her abdomen, on the lower part, and going down the leg. Sometimes it goes down the leg right here, and they might think it's the rectus femoris or, you know, the quads, but it's really the psoas, the iliacus, because now they've, you know, they've joined here. The iliopsoas have joined right around here. So you wanna, okay, I found, okay. Something that you have to be real careful, if you are on the right side of the body, you have to look out underneath your fingertips that you're not on the iliocecal valve, on the appendix, the femoral artery. Remember, if you feel a pulse, stay off of it, because that would be the femoral artery, or the inguinal ligament. So in order for you to find out if you are on the correct, if you're on the iliopsoas, again, you ask them to lift. You're right underneath here. And I'm going to go in real slowly. And I should feel that muscle. Okay, bend, lift up your leg. Lift your, towards you. Okay. Nope, I'm not on it. Okay, right there. Lift your leg again. Lift your leg up. Right there. I felt it. Right underneath my fingertips, I can feel that muscle. You want to make sure that you are on the muscle and not on any of those, you know, other, you know, like the artery or the nerve or the iliocecal valve, or if somebody has a flared up appendix, they're going to feel pain. And the way you distinguish that is that you make sure that she lifts her leg up and then puts it back down, and you can feel that muscle because it lifts your leg up. This muscle brings you into hip flexion. So this is the motion of the psoas major and the iliacus. And together they form the iliopsoas. So it's two muscles combined in one. Okay, so once you're right here and you're sure that you're on the iliopsoas, you know, right by the ilium, you might want to do some strain counter strain. So what I'm going to do, she's not going to do so much of the movement. It's going to be passive movement. You know, I'm going to lift up her leg myself so it can relax even more. And you might, you know, my fingers underneath are just moving, you know, and holding, I'm holding this up a little bit. You can also rotate it in, you know, medially, or rotate it out, you know, laterally. So this also helps loosen up that tendon attachment and the iliopsoas. And this is really good, like when you're holding that trigger point, you can hold it right here for about 15 to 20 seconds while you're holding that trigger point. And then you let the leg down slowly. You want to be able to engage some of those same movements so that it'll start releasing. Now the third trigger point that you're gonna treat is, okay, you may put your legs down. We are gonna go down to the insertion. So they comes here and it inserts at the lesser trochanter. The tendon of the iliacus and the psoas major combines and it comes into the lesser trochanter of the femur, and you can feel it, you know. And don't use too much pressure because this is a very sensitive area. You might feel the femoral artery here, so make sure again that you're on the tendon. And one of the ways that you can make sure is by asking her to bend her knee towards her. Okay, that right there. I felt it right away underneath my fingertips. Again, you ask your client to breathe two or three times. You ask her what level of pain is it right there? No pain. So she doesn't have pain in the insertion. However, she had pain on the belly of the muscle more than she did here and right here on the, this is the other. So this is the first trigger point, second trigger point, third trigger point. She doesn't have any pain here, which is a good sign. It's a good sign that it's not the insertion. However, if it did hurt, again, you would only hold it for about 15 seconds, half her breathe through it, and don't go above a 5 or a 6. So this is the strongest hip flexor and the strongest hip, okay. This is the strongest hip flexor, and the strongest hip extensor is the glutes. So you always want to check the glutes, because a lot of times the glutes are hypertonic and, you know, and are pulling you into a posterior, tilt. And this one, after you've treated, you want to make sure that they're balanced. You know, muscles get out of line because they're not balanced. So you want to make sure and treat the gluteus maximus. Oh, I'm going to show you sideline, because actually that's one of my favorites. So let's turn her on her side. That's another way to reach the psoas major and the iliacus. Okay, so when you turn your client sideways, you always want to support the top leg. The bottom leg is straight, and support the cervicals. Make sure her back is straight. But right here, it's a excellent way to reach the psoas and the iliacus, because the abdominals kind of fall, you know, gravity pulls them towards the table, so they're easier to access. Again, you find where their belly button is, 2 inches out, 2 inches down, you're gonna get to the belly of it. So you wanna do circular motions and ask your client to take a deep breath. And then on the exhale, you push down a little bit until, and you can do this a couple of times. Okay, one more deep breath. And then on the exhale, I go down just a little bit more. See if I can feel it. Is it as tender as it was? Is it still a 6 like it was when you were supine?
Five.
No, it went down. So now it's a 5. So this is good. And like I said, you just, you know, let her breathe through it. You hold it, you know, static pressure until it starts releasing. So this is a great way to get, again, to the psoas major. Now you release slowly. And remember, you want to use the pads, not the fingertip, not the fingertips. Now to get to the iliacus, this is an excellent way, because here's the ASIS, the most anterior superior iliac spine of the iliac. Now I can dig in. Oh, I'm sorry. Is that cold? Be real gentle. But I'm cupping, really getting to the iliacus right there. Oh, and I can feel I'm on it. Is that hurt?
No.
It tickles?
No.
No?
It's tense?
Yeah. And yeah, I can really feel it. This is right there. I can feel it. And again, this one moves the iliocecal valve and, you know, the appendix out of the way, because it's being pulled by gravity towards the table. So this is probably an easier access for you guys, not to, if you're not sure if you're on the iliocecal valve or the appendix, this might be better. You're finding the bony part, the ASIS, and you're going underneath, and you always want to go in on the exhale. Okay, this is an excellent way, and all I'm doing is back and forth, you know, superior, inferior, medial and lateral movements. Just really trying to get to the, you know, in the back of the ilium here. And you can also do some movements. Yeah, this is intense work, guys. You know, people that have low back pain, a lot of times it's not the quadratus lumborum, it is the psoas. And remember, the psoas crosses diagonally from the, you know, from the lumbars, it crosses diagonally to insert on the, you know, lesser trochanter of the femur. So it crosses diagonally, and it's difficult to palpate. It's a real difficult muscle to get to, so be careful, be gentle. Another thing that I want you to teach your clients is that when they get up, especially if they're on the supine position, they should never get straight back up, because that'll strain that muscle. You want to show them to roll over and get up from bed on the, you know, from the sideline or from your table, sideline position. The tight iliacus is very common with runners, with dancers, with gymnasts, with women, you know, pregnant women that carry, you know, that weight of the baby. It puts pressure on the inguinal ligament. So you want to treat this muscle for people, especially, you know, that run, because in that motion, when they're running and lifting their leg, it'll, you know, get hypertonic. So this is a great way to treat those three trigger points, sideline, and supine, and I hope that this will help you. And until the next time, create a great day.